So up to last classes, we have discussed the elasticity chapter. Okay. Today, I'm going to start the new chapter, surface tension. So before going to discuss different topics in the surface tension, let us know what is the coercive force and what is the adhesive force. First, coercive force. The force of attraction present between the similar molecules. The force of attraction present between the similar molecules is called the coercive force. Suppose if we take the water, the force of attraction present between the two similar molecules means water molecules. All are water molecules only. Between any two same type of molecules like water molecules or kerosene molecules. Okay, like that. If you take the force of attraction present between the two similar molecules or same type of molecules is called the coercive force. So force between force of attraction between similar molecules is called the coercive force. Okay, next, adhesive forces. The force of attraction between dissimilar molecules. Force of attraction between the dissimilar molecules, that is called the adhesive force. Because of adhesive force only, gum sticks to the paper. Gum sticks to the paper. Okay. In that case, the adhesive forces between the molecules of the gum and the paper are very strong compared with the coercive forces among the molecules of the gum. Gumlone molecules madhyane coercive force kante kuda gumlone molecules ki paper yokka surface unna molecules madhye gala adhesive force endukante in between the paper molecules and the gum molecules of the gum are adhesive. Adhesive forces are stronger than coercive forces. Due to that, the gum sticks to the paper. Suppose we take the mercury on the paper. Is the mercury sticks to the paper? If you take the small part of the small volume of the mercury pledge on the paper, is the mercury sticks to the paper? No, because the adhesive forces between mercury atoms and some molecules on the surface of the paper is less compared with the coercive forces among the mercury atoms. That means coercive forces are stronger than adhesive forces. In such case, because of that reason, the mercury molecules or mercury cannot stick to the paper, cannot stick to the glass. Okay, so here, because of adhesive force only, water wets the floor. The liquid which wets the surface. In such case, the adhesive forces are stronger than the coercive forces. If any liquid does not wet the solid surface on which it is taken, in such case, definitely coercive forces are stronger than the adhesive forces. Okay, so I think you are having clarity about what is coercive force and what is adhesive forces. Okay, I think you know, you got the clarity about what is coercive forces and adhesive forces. Okay, now what is the surface tension? Okay, suppose if you observe the raindrop, in raindrop there are number of water molecules are there. Among the water molecules, what are the types of forces exist? Are they adhesive or coercive? Among the water molecules, coercive forces exist. So because of coercive forces, here suppose this is water molecule. Here, all water molecules on the surface of the water drop or raindrop, are attracted by the molecules inside the water drop. That's why each and every molecule inside the raindrop attracts the molecules on the surface of the raindrop inwards. Due to that, all the molecules on the surface of the raindrop try to come into the raindrop. Because of attraction, cohesive force of attraction acts on the molecules on the surface of the raindrop by the molecules inside it. Due to attraction forces, all the molecules on the surface of the raindrop, because of cohesive force of attraction by the molecules inside it, all the molecules on the surface of the raindrop try to come into the liquid so that the surface of the liquid is smooth. It is just like a stretched elastic membrane. And whenever all the molecules over the surface of the raindrop try to come inside the liquid, then the liquid drop occupies the as possible as minimum volume. For the given volume of the liquid to occupy the minimum volume, what is the shape to be acquired? For the given volume of the liquid drop to occupy the minimum volume, for the given liquid drop, to have the minimum volume, what is the shape to be acquired? What minimum surface area, what is the shape to be acquired? For the given volume of the liquid drop to acquire the minimum surface area, what is the shape to be acquired? Because whenever all molecules over the surface of liquid drop try to come inside the liquid, so that the number of molecules on the surface of the liquid decreases and becomes minimum, and the surface area becomes minimum. For the given volume of the liquid drop to have the minimum surface area, what is the shape to be acquired? Spherical shape. That's why, because here this property of the liquid drop or the property of the surface of the liquid, due to which this surface acquires the minimum surface area, minimum area, that is called the surface tension. So the property of the liquid surface due to which the property of the free liquid surface due to which it acquires the minimum surface area is called the surface tension. That is the general definition for surface tension. Okay, general definition for surface tension. So it is the qualitative definition of the surface tension. So what is the qualitative definition of the surface tension? Means the property of the surface of the liquid due to which its surface, it acquires the minimum surface area is called surface tension. The property of the liquid due to which it acquires the minimum surface area is called the surface tension. So because of cohesive forces among the molecules of the molecules on the surface are attracted by molecules inside the drop, due to that the number of molecules on the surface of the liquid decreases as the molecules on the surface go into the liquid drop. The number of molecules present on the surface of the liquid drop decreases and acquires the minimum surface area. That property of the liquid due to which it acquires the minimum surface area is called surface tension. So because of this reason only, raindrops acquires the spherical shape. So because of surface tension property only, it is the qualitative definition of the surface tension. So example, raindrops acquire minimum surface area. Raindrops acquire spherical shape. Not acquire the minimum surface area, the raindrop must be having acquires the spherical shape. So raindrops acquire spherical shape because of surface tension property. Raindrops acquires a spherical shape because of surface tension property. Okay, next, one more example. Suppose if you see the surface of the stagnant water. Kusumakar, what is your doubt? Kusumakar? Okay, liquid drop in concert. Initially, the liquid drop is not spherical in shape. Kusumakar, you imagine the liquid drop. Initially, you treat that the liquid drop is not spherical shape. Here, every molecule on the surface of the liquid drop is attracted by the molecules present inside the liquid drop because of cohesive forces. Due to that, all the molecules over the surface of liquid, due to cohesive forces, as they are attracted into the liquid, the molecules on the surface of liquid try to come inside the liquid. Due to that, the number of molecules on the surface of liquid decreases. so that it acquires the minimum surface area. For the given volume of liquid drop to have the minimum surface area, what is the shape to be acquired? Ichina volume of the drop ki minimum surface area undalante ye shape ni acquire cheyali? Spherical shape. So because of that reason, every raindrop, every free raindrop acquires the spherical shape due to surface tension. Okay, Kusmaka. No. For the given volume of liquid, surface area is minimum for sphere only. For the given volume of liquid drop, not to have the minimum surface area, the shape to be acquired must be sphere only. Any other shape is acquired like cone or a cube, whatever it may be, it is having more surface area. Only for the sphere only the surface area is minimum. Okay, Smarter. For the given volume of liquid drop to have the minimum surface area, that liquid drop must acquire the spherical shape because it is having minimum surface area for the given volume. That's why every free liquid drop must acquire the will acquire the spherical shape. Next, I think you know the surface of the stagnant water in drains, etc., drainages, etc. You know the surface of the stagnant water. On the surface of the stagnant water, insects can crawl over the surface of the stagnant water. Sometimes you can see on the surface of the stagnant water, the mustro breeds are floating over the surface of the stagnant water. On the surface of the stagnant water, a mustro breed will float over the surface of the stagnant water. Because of surface tension property, all the molecules on the surface of the liquid try to come inside the liquid. Due to that, all molecules comes closer, hence the surface area becomes so smooth. Whenever all the molecules try to come inside, due to that all the molecules are comes very nearer to each other, so that the surface of the any liquid, surface of any liquid appears like a stretched elastic membrane. Stretched elastic membrane means you take the elastic rubber paper, you stretch them, and how it appears like a smooth surface. Here, the surface of the stagnant water also behaves like a surface of the stretched elastic membrane. Due to that, when you keep any object over them, then because of elastic property, some reaction force acts on the object in upward direction. Due to that, a mustro breed floats over the surface of the stagnant water because of elastic property only. Here, but in case of liquid drop, surface of the liquid, due to surface tension property, surface of any liquid behaves like a stretched elastic membrane because of surface tension. So, free surface of the liquid, free surface of a liquid, or stagnant water, in drains. Free surface of a stagnant water behaves like, not a stagnant water, anyone, free surface of a liquid. In general, right? Free surface of a liquid behaves like a stretched elastic membrane. Free surface of a liquid behaves like a stretched elastic membrane because of surface tension. Due to that, the free surface of stagnant water, the free surface, that means upper surface, free surface of stagnant water means the surface of the given water or given liquid, which is exposed to atmosphere, that is the free surface of the water or liquid. Due to that, a free surface behaves like, acts like a bedding place for mosquito breed. That is due to surface tension. So, the property of liquid by means of which, the given volume of the liquid drop acquires the minimum surface area. is called surface tension. That is one qualitative definition of the surface tension. Next one, the property of the liquid, that means of which it's a surface, behaves like a surface stretched elastic membrane. That is also called as the surface tension. That is also one more qualitative definition of the surface tension. But how we can measure? How we can measure? That definition gives a quantitative definition of the surface tension. So what is the quantitative definition of the surface tension? Now you see, suppose in a beaker you take the water. The beaker is filled with water. Can you see the surface of the water in a beaker or surface of the liquid in a beaker taken? The shape is like this. As the beaker is in the form of a cylindrical cylinder, the surface of liquid appears like a circle. Surface of the liquid in the beaker appears like a circle. Okay. On the surface of the liquid, just you draw a line by means of a scale. Is it possible to draw a line on the surface of the liquid? No. We can imagine, no? So on the surface of the liquid, you imagine a line. Suppose here a line is imagined like this. Which is called imagined line on the surface of the liquid. As it is on the surface of the liquid, number of molecules are there on the this line imagined on the surface of the liquid, no? So these are the number of molecules or number of atoms on the surface of the liquid lies on the imagined line having length L. So imagined line is taken on the surface of the liquid and the molecules are considered on the surface of the liquid. All these molecules are attracted by the adjacent molecules. All these molecules on the imaginary line are attracted by the adjacent molecules due to Cauchy force. No, the liquid at the surface, the line in imaginary line in the molecules, adjacent molecules, Cauchy force attract just like itla directional. Suppose if you consider the adjacent molecules here, all these molecules are attracted in this direction. If you consider here, all these molecules are attracted in this direction. Right? Okay. Here the adjacent molecules attracts all the molecules sliced on the imaginary line in one direction due to cohesive forces. So the net cohesive force acts on all the molecules on this imaginary line is equal to say F. So F is the cohesive force acts on imaginary line of length L imagined on the surface of the liquid. So on the imaginary line of length L, the cohesive force acts. Due to adjacent molecules is equal to say F. Then Cauchy force acts on unit length of imaginary line drawn on the surface of the liquid means F by L. That is equal to surface tension capital T or S. In some books it is given represented with S. In some books, it is represented with capital T, whatever may be symbol. Okay. So, Cauchy force acts on unit length of the imaginary line drawn on the surface of the liquid is called a surface tension. That is the definition of the surface tension. So, a Cauchy force acts on unit length of imaginary line, drawn on the surface of the liquid. A Cauchy force acts on unit length of imaginary line drawn on the surface of the liquid is called surface tension. It is the quantitative definition of the surface tension. By means of quantitative definition, we can assess or we can calculate the surface tension of the given liquid. So is it a scalar or vector? Suppose when you consider the imaginary line here, the surface tension in this direction. If you imagine the imaginary line in this direction, surface tension in this direction. If you consider the imaginary line like this, surface tension is in this direction or in this direction. That's why surface tension is not having proper direction. It is also a concern. Based on the direction of the molecule, based on the molecules considered here, the direction of the cohesive force depends. That's why it is also a tensor force. It is neither a scalar nor a vector, just like moment of inertia. It is also a tensor. Okay, what is the SI unit of the surface tension? What is the SI unit of the surface tension? SI unit. Force means Newton, length means meter, Newton per meter. And what is the dimension formula of surface tension? Dimension formula of surface tension. Dimension formula of P is equal to dimension formula of F by dimension formula of L. Dimension formula of F is ML square T to the power of minus 2. ML T to the power of minus 2. By length L. LL cancels. So M T to the power of minus 2 is the dimension formula of the surface tension. So dimension formula of the surface tension is equal to dimension formula of surface tension is equal to M T to the power of minus 2. So that is the dimension formula of the surface tension. Okay. Now now related to surface tension, some important note points we have to discuss. First one, according to the definition of the surface tension T is equal to, surface tension capital T is equal to cohesive force by length of the imaginary line, F by L. Okay, then what is the force due to surface tension acts on the imaginary line of length L? Cohesive force or force due to surface tension? Force due to surface tension, comma, F is equal to T into L. T means surface tension into L means the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body. Here in this formula, L means length of liquid surface in contact with the body, or we can imagine length of the imaginary line. Okay, so we can imagine T into L means length of the free liquid surface. Length of free liquid surface. Length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body. In contact with the body. Suppose one example I want to discuss here. Example. Suppose one wire. Suppose this is the wire of length. This is the wire of length L. Is kept over the surface of the liquid. This is the wire of length L. Kept over the surface of the liquid. It is floating. It is floating over the surface of the liquid. Okay, then when you see the wire from this cross section, when you see the wire from this cross section in this direction, then the wire seems to be floating over the surface of liquid like this. It is the surface of liquid. When you see the cross section, through cross section of the wire, then we can see the surface, the cross section of the wire is like this. Here the wire is floating over the surface of liquid. Then suppose you see, this is the wire of length L. It is kept over the surface of the liquid and it is floating, say. If it is floating, then it is floating means a part of the volume of this is submerged in the liquid. And on this side liquid is there, on this side also liquid is there. So suppose if the length of this pen is L, then on this surface, on this side, on right side of this pencil, what is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the pen? This thickness can be ignored. The thickness negligible anukondi. What is the length of the free liquid surface? Free liquid surface means that is the surface of the liquid which is exposed to atmosphere. And what is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the pen? That is L. On this side also L, no? This is L. This is L. So what is the total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body? What is the total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body? 2L. 2L. So the total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire. This is same. Wire and this are same. So this side L, this side L. Totally, the total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire is equal to 2 times the length of the wire. That means 2L. Then in order to remove this wire from the surface of the liquid against the surface tension. Because why this wire is removing from the surface of the liquid, the molecules, you see, while it is removing from the surface of the liquid, the shape of the liquid becomes like this. Suppose we are removing the wire from the surface of the liquid, then on this between the circle, between the molecules lies on the surface of the liquid and the molecules of the wire. Because of adhesive forces, they stick together like this. When you want to remove this wire from the surface of the liquid, because of adhesive forces between the molecules on the surface of the liquid and the molecules of the wire, they cling or they attract to this wire. So, against the surface tension, in order to remove the wire from the surface of the liquid, what is the force required? Means that force required is equal to surface tension into length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire. It is the length of the free surface of the liquid. And it, here also, this side also. So total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire is equal to this one. Okay, that is equal to 2L. Therefore, force required to remove the wire from the surface of liquid. Against the surface tension alone, because against the weight of the wire also we have to apply. But yeah, we are talking about only against the surface tension. In order to remove the wire, what is the force required? Means the force required to remove the wire from the surface of the liquid against the surface tension only. Against the surface tension, F is equal to surface tension T into length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire is equal to 2L. This is the formula. Once it was given in mix, where L is the length of the wire, T is the surface tension, T, surface tension, L, length of the wire. One more example, if I explain, you can understand clearly. Another example. It is A. Okay, this is the general formula for surface tension. In that example A, here dimensional formula surface tension means dimensional formula force ML T to power of minus 2 by length L. LL cancel. So M T to power of minus 2 is the dimensional formula surface tension. M for 1, L to power of 0, T to power of minus 2 we can write. Okay, SNT, you know, it is a tensor. It is tensor, not vector, not scalar. It is a tensor. Okay, right. Force due to surface tension. F is equal to T into L. This one. Okay, now third one. Okay, here you write A. Example. Third one. First example. Third note point. First example A. Okay. Force due to surface tension acts on the wire is equal to a formula is that one. Next, B. Suppose on the surface of the liquid, a rectangular plate is floating. That may be wooden plate or whatever it may be. It is floating over the surface of the liquid. Floating means it is not submerged inside the liquid. Okay? So this is the floating body. floating body of length L, breadth B. Length L and breadth B. What is the force due to surface tension? What is the force required to pull the rectangle plate away from the surface of liquid against the surface tension? Surface of the liquid pai nunchi against the surface tension ee plate ni mana remove cheyalante what is the force required? Tell me. Force required is called F into F is equal to surface tension into length L, effective length L. Length of the liquid surface in contact with the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body. Tell me what is the length of free liquid surface in contact with the body here? Oka plate liquid ayaka surface meeda float avutunappudu ichondi. Suppose this is the rectangular plate, length L, breadth B. It is floating over the surface of liquid. Then the liquid surface is in contact with the adjacent side of this duster, razor. This side. That means what is the total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body means this is L, this is L, 2L, this is B, 2B. 2L plus 2B is the total length of the liquid surface in contact with the floating body now. That's why. So, the force required to pull the body, the force required to pull the rectangle plate against the surface tension is equal to P into 2L plus 2B. That means 2 of L plus B. Where 2L plus 2B is the total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body. I think you could have some clarity based on this example. I will discuss one more example so that you can have 100% clarity about the total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body. Suppose we are given a circular disc is floating over the surface of the liquid. A circular disc is floating over the surface of the liquid. See, one circular disc is floating over the surface of the body. The radius is r. It is floating over the surface of the liquid. In order to remove the body, in order to remove the disc against the surface tension, what is the force required? Force required F is equal to remove the body circular disc from the surface of liquid against the surface tension. What is the force required? Force required is equal to surface tension into what is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the disc here when it is floating over the surface of liquid? When it is floating over the surface of the liquid, what is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the floating ball disc? Yeah, very good. That's all. Sriram, that is only answer. Here, you see, whenever it is floating, the circumference of the body is in contact with the free liquid surface, no? That's why length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body is how much means? 2 pi r only. 2 pi into radius r. That's all. That is the answer. It is only the force required to move the disc against the surface tension only. Surface tension against ga ee body manam pull cheyalante baitiki. Surface of the liquid to contact loose it ga cheyalante what is the minimum force required means this is the minimum force required to move the disc remove the disc against the surface tension from the surface of the liquid. Suppose here an annular disc of inner radius smaller outer radius capital, okay, it is floating over the surface of the liquid. It is floating over the surface of liquid. Annular disc. Annular disc means it is the disc having hole. Annular disc. Okay. So what is the force required? What is the force required to remove the annular disc from the surface of liquid against the surface tension? Surface tension into what is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body? Very good. 2 pi of capital R plus small r. Ashwant, capital R plus small r, no? The outer circumference, the free liquid surface is in contact. The inner circumference also free. Here hole is there, no? Annular disc means hole is there. It is also the free surface of liquid only. The length of the free liquid surface here in contact with the inner hole is equal to 2 pi small r. So total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the body or in contact with the annular disc is equal to 2 pi capital R plus 2 pi small r. That is equal to capital T into 2 pi you take common, capital R plus small r. Very good. This is the answer. Okay, Bashwant, are you followed now? Bashwant. Okay. So this is another one. Suppose on the surface of liquid, then on the surface of the liquid, when a body is kept on the surface of liquid, a sphere is kept over the surface of liquid. It is floating such that half of the volume of the sphere is inside the liquid. Then what is the force required to remove the sphere from the surface of the liquid against the surface tension? Sphere float out only. One sphere is floating over the surface of the liquid. So that half of the volume of the body is submerged in a liquid. Half of the volume of the body is submerged in a liquid. Half of the volume is definitely the surface of the liquid is passing through center of the sphere. It is floating over the surface of the liquid like this. Okay. Then, what is the force required against the surface tension to remove the sphere from the surface of liquid? That is what question mark. Suppose the radius of the sphere is a capital R. Then here with the circumference, here the diametrical plane, the circumference of the sphere passing lies within the plane, lies passing through center. That is, the liquid surface is a plane passing through center. That's why the total length of the liquid surface in contact with the sphere is equal to 2 pi capital R. No? So T into 2 pi capital R is the minimum force required to remove the sphere from the surface of the liquid against the surface tension only. Inka deeniki weight sambandhinchina force ni kuda apply chesthe bayatiki bayatiki remove avutundi. Adiki matladatle ikkada. We are discussing only force required to remove the sphere against the surface tension only. That's why T into 2 pi R, where T is the surface tension. On what factor surface tension depends? Sometimes you will be given the same problem, you will be given like this. Suppose it is the center. The sphere is floating over the surface of liquid so that a part of the sphere only, not half of the volume of the sphere, a part of the volume of the sphere only submerged in the liquid. And it is floating like this. In this case, of course, this is equal to radius R. This is also equal to radius R. Okay. Here the liquid surface is, free liquid surface is in contact with the sphere along this plane, in this plane. Okay. Here center. Suppose this distance is equal to say small r. This circle region undi kada. Deeni yokka circumference radius small r anukunte. What is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the solid sphere? What is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the solid sphere? If radius of the, here no doubt, around the sphere, around the solid sphere, the shape of the free liquid surface in contact with the solid sphere is circle of radius smaller. Then what is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the solid sphere? Means 2 pi smaller. Smaller is not given. Capital R is given. And the surface of the liquid, is the center of the sphere is at a height small h. The center of the sphere is at a height small h from the surface of this liquid in the beaker. That is given. Small r is not given. So from this, what is small r? Small r is equal to square root of capital R square minus h square. No? Therefore, force due to surface, force required to remove the sphere from against the surface tension is equal to T into circumference 2 pi small r. That is called T into 2 pi small r means square root of capital R square minus h square. That write like this. Yeah. 2 pi into root capital R square minus h square. So this is the force required against the surface tension to remove the sphere from the surface of the liquid. So in this way, you have to do. Okay. Next. Next example. What is the minimum radius of the wire? Suppose this is a wire floating over the surface of the liquid. It is floating over the surface of liquid. Wire is floating over the surface of liquid like this. Wire is floating over the surface of the liquid. Okay. Whenever it is floating over the surface of liquid, then suppose if the what is the minimum radius of the wire so that it is floating over the surface of liquid? Bend force can be neglected because minimum radius they asked. And minimum radius, radius of the wire is a smaller, length is a young. Minimum radius is R minimum. So for minimum radius of the wire, minimum radius of wire which is floating over the surface of a liquid. Minimum radius of the wire which is floating over the surface of the liquid against the surface tension only. Against the surface tension is R minimum is equal to R minimum is R minimum which is equal to dash. So whenever this wire is floating over the surface of the liquid, okay, suppose if you see the cross section like this. From this cross section, if you see the wire, then it is floating over the surface of liquid. Weight mg acts vertically downwards direction. Weight mg acts vertically downwards direction. Okay. Here actually, at the surface of the wire, whenever the water is in contact, if you see the surface of the water, the surface is not plane. It is just curvature like this. It is just curvature like this. Okay, then force due to surface tension acts on the molecule due to remaining molecules of the surface of liquid is downwards. At the same time, adhesive forces acts on the wire in this direction. That is equal to surface tension. So force due to surface tension here, adhesive forces acts on the molecules of the wire at this point against the surface tension is equal to surface tension. A component of this one acts vertically upwards. Component of this one acts vertically upwards. So along the length of the wire, the component of the surface tension acts on the wire in upward direction. What is that component? Suppose this angle is say theta. This angle is say theta. Then suppose this angle is say theta. Then P cos theta is the surface tension component acts at the edge of the wire in vertically upward direction. Okay, into total length of the wire in contact with the total length of the free surface of liquid in contact with the wire upwards is equal to 2L. It is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire. P cos theta is the surface tension component acts on the wire along vertically upward direction. It is the total force due to surface tension acts on the wire in vertically upward direction. Weight mg acts vertically downwards direction. Weight mg acts vertically downwards direction. Here bind force is also there, but they ask the minimum radius of the wire now. The minimum radius of the wire means the weight must be balanced by force due to surface tension only. If weight is also there, then radius will be more. That's why for minimum radius, the force due to surface tension only acts on the wire in upward direction. That is equal to weight mg. Therefore, from this P is equal to mg by 2L into cos theta. For minimum, okay, this is equal to, what is M? M means mass of the wire. Mass of the wire means area of cross section pi r square, because radius is considered as r square. Area of cross section pi r square into length of the wire gives volume, into density of the wire gives mass, into z, by 2L cos theta. So here LL cancel. Okay. Therefore, radius we need. from this r square is equal to do cross multiplication 2t cos theta r square is equal to 2t cos theta by 2t cos theta by pi rho z as we do not consider the buoyant force here definitely this weight here the force due to surface tension alone balances the weight okay from this minimum radius is equal to this is the minimum radius therefore r is equal to r minimum that is equal to question mark so r minimum squared is equal to 2t cos theta by pi rho z so r minimum is equal to root 2t cos theta by pi rho z okay here for water and wire suppose this angle theta is equal to 0 degree theta is 0 degree then minimum radius is equal to 2t by pi rho z so the minimum radius of the wire for which it is floating over the surface of liquid means root 2t by pi rho z so the here this radius does not depends on the length of the wire because length of the wire term is cancelled that's why the minimum radius of the wire for which it is floating over the surface of liquid does not depends on the length of the wire therefore r minimum does not depends on length of the wire the minimum radius of the wire does not depends on the length of the wire that is very very important okay so here it is the minimum radius of the wire for which it is floating over the surface of the liquid the minimum radius of the wire for which it is floating over the surface of the liquid means you take water for water wire theta is equal to 0 you take what is theta we'll explain this will come in later classes okay so for water wire if theta is equal to 0 degree if theta is equal to 0 degree then r minimum is equal to root 2t by pi rho z This minimum radius does not depend on the length of the wire because L is not involved in this formula. Okay, so here again I am explaining. Somebody else asked me. Whenever the wire is kept over the surface of liquid, if it is floating over the surface of liquid, what is the minimum radius of the wire? They asked. So here, whenever the wire is kept over the surface of liquid, weight mg acts vertically downwards direction. Okay, at the same time. Oh, because of force here the surface of the liquid is like this whenever the when we want to remove the you see whenever it is sorry in this case you see the surface of the liquid is like this it is having concave surface like this at this point of contact I will draw here this diagram here clearly suppose the surface of the liquid when you observe the surface of the liquid is like this At this point of contact, if you draw the tangent to this liquid surface, if you draw that is in this direction. It is the force due to surface tension, or coercive force due to surface tension acts at this point in this direction. At the same time, because of attraction force between the molecules of the wire and water molecule, this water molecule, the force, adhesive forces acts on the molecule in this direction, opposite to the surface tension. T. That is equal to numerical equal to T. Okay. Suppose with vertical, the angle made by this surface tension, with the angle made by this surface tension, with this surface body inside the liquid, that is say theta. Then this is equal to theta. Then this component along vertical direction is equal to t cos theta. So on the surface on the wire along vertical direction, surface tension component is t cos theta. So what is the total force acts on the total total adhesive force acts on the wire against the surface tension means t cos theta into 2l that acts vertically upwards whenever it balances the weight of the wire then it is floating over the surface of the liquid whenever the wire is floating over the surface of the liquid then as they asked the minimum radius then the buoyant force should not consider for the minimum radius okay because this radius is very small compared with the length that's why A buoyant force can be ignored. So only force due to surface tension, force due to surface tension acts on the wire in upward direction. That is equal to T cos theta into 2L. That is equal to Mg. Or T is equal to Mg by something. Simplification gives answer. And here, surface tension wala panche suppose inverse pan chestunte that is suppose that opposite direction action reaction opposite direction lo pan chestundi manaku component vertical ga t cos theta so because of this vertical component t cos theta what is the force acts on the wire in upward direction means total length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire is 2l surface tension component vertical upwards is equal to t cos theta so t cos theta into 2l is equal to mc okay okay Kutzmacher so from this mass of the wire means area of cross section of the wire r square into length of the wire gives volume into rho gives density rho gives mass rho is the density into g is the weight by 2l cos theta l are cancelled so when you simplify them I got minimum radius is equal to root 2 t by pi rho g in this there is no length of the wire that means the minimum radius of the wire when it is floating over the surface of liquid does not depends on the length of the wire the minimum radius does not depends on the length of the wire when wire is floating okay Kutzmacher okay Kutzmacher force here surface tension acts inwards due to cohesive forces at the same time between the surface of the wire and the molecule of the liquid the same force or adhesive force acts on the molecule in upward direction opposite to the surface tension in this direction their component along vertical upward direction is t cos theta therefore total force total adhesive force acts on the wire in upward direction on the total length of the wire is equal to 2 cos theta t cos theta into 2l that is the total force acts on the wire vertically upwards 8 mg downwards whenever these two are equal then only it is floating over the surface of the liquid okay therefore t cos theta into 2l is equal to mg okay okay Kutzmacher next these are the some important note points sphere of influence next siding sphere of influence and surface film sphere of influence and surface film first we have to know molecular range of attraction molecular range of attraction molecular range of attraction okay here sphere of influence comma surface film and molecular range of attraction right and molecular range of attraction first molecular range of attraction first here you write molecular range of attraction in a liquid the maximum distance between the molecules up to which one molecule attracts the other molecule that distance is called molecular range of attraction so the maximum distance up to which the cohesive force of attraction exists between two molecules of a liquid is called the molecular range of attraction so maximum distance the maximum distance between the molecules. The maximum distance between the molecules up to which cohesive force between them exists. Cohesive force between them exist is called molecular range of attraction. Is called molecular range of attraction. The maximum distance between the molecules of a liquid up to which cohesive force between them exist is called molecular range of attraction. Here this order is approximately this range. This range is in the order of 10⁻⁹ meter. The molecular range of attraction is approximately 10⁻⁹ meter. All range lo untundi. Okay. Now, on the surface of liquid, suppose in a beaker we have taken the liquid. It is the surface of the liquid. In this liquid, suppose we have taken the liquid in a beaker up to certain level. Okay, inside the liquid, by taking the molecule as the center, by taking the any one of the molecules at the center, and the molecular range of attraction as the radius, you imagine the sphere. You imagine the sphere. Similarly here also, by taking the molecule at the center and molecular range of attraction as the radius, you imagine the sphere like this. Then in this sphere, you see, in this sphere, every molecule in this sphere is attracted by the molecule at the center. Now, because this is the molecular, this sphere is having radius r, which is the molecular range of attraction. So every molecule in this sphere is attracted by the molecule at the center. That's why every molecule in this sphere, every molecule of liquid lies in this sphere, is influenced by the molecule at the center. That's why this sphere is called the sphere of influence. This sphere is called sphere of influence. So this is called sphere of influence. Sphere of influence. Sphere of influence. Which has molecular range of attraction as the radius. Molecular range as radius. That is important. Next, surface film. By taking the molecular range of attraction as the thickness of the liquid film from its surface, if you imagine the liquid surface, ikkada nunchi ikkada varaku the thickness, molecular range of attraction people, molecular range of attraction. So when you imagine the surface of liquid surface from the surface of liquid whose thickness is equal to molecular range of attraction, then that surface is called, that thin film is called the surface film. So this is the surface film. What is the thickness of the surface film? Thickness of surface film. Thickness of surface film is in the order of molecular range of attraction only, because the thickness of the surface film is equal to molecular range of attraction. That's why thickness of the surface film is in the order of molecular range of attraction. Molecular range of attraction. That means it is in the order of 10⁻⁹ meter. Every molecule in the surface film is attracted by the molecule. Every molecule in the surface film is attracted by the adjacent molecules. Okay? Because between this, any two adjacent molecules, the distance is less than this or equal to maximum this. That's why here every molecule in this film is attracted by the molecule on the surface. Surface inner molecule ki inner molecules ki madhya distance definitely ga molecular range of attraction equal ga undochu ledha less than undochu. Okay, that's why every molecule on the surface of liquid is attracted by the molecules present below the surface of liquid, as thickness of this film is equal to or less than molecular range of attraction. So this film is called the surface film. Okay. So now, surface energy and work done to increase the surface area against the surface tension. Against the surface tension. Surface energy and work done to increase the surface area against the surface tension. Surface energy and work done to increase the surface area against the surface tension. Because of surface tension, every molecule on the surface of liquid try to come inside the liquid. But against the surface tension, we have to increase the surface area. To increase the surface area, number of molecules on the surface of liquid must be increased. That means against the surface tension, we have to move the molecules outwards so that surface area will increase. For that, we have to do some work. What is the amount of work done to increase the surface area? It's a very, very important point in this chapter. Okay. Suppose you take a soap solution in the beaker. You take a soap solution in the beaker. Okay. Now, that soap solution is having surface tension, say capital T. Soap solution is having surface tension capital T. Okay. Now, you take a U-shaped metal frame. You take a U-shaped metal frame. It is the U-shaped metal frame having breadth B. Breadth of the metal frame is a B. You take U-shaped metal frame having breadth B. You take a U-shaped metal frame having breadth B. Okay. Over this metal frame, there is a sliding wire. Over this metal frame, there is a sliding wire like this. Here, in between the sliding wire and these two parallel rails, two parallel wires are there, no? In between two parallel wires and the sliding wire, there is no friction. Smooth. There is no friction between this wire and this wire. This wire can be moved freely. This wire can be slided freely over the two parallel wires. Okay? In such a way, we have taken an arrangement. Okay, now, suppose this U-shaped metal frame with a sliding wire. Whenever the sliding wire is there, immediately this is a closed loop, no? This becomes a closed loop. Now, you dip this U-shaped metal frame with sliding wire inside the soap solution and just you remove that. Then soap film is formed between soap film is formed in this closed loop, am I right? Suppose if you take a small circular ring, you dip a small circular ring in the soap solution and you remove them outside. Then a circular soap film is formed in the ring, no? Similarly, here also, whenever this U-shaped metal frame with sliding wire, it is the sliding wire. This is the sliding wire. Sliding wire. So, whenever you submerge the U-shaped metal frame with sliding wire inside the soap solution and when you remove them, and a soap film is formed here. Soap film is formed here. How many free surfaces are there for the soap film? How many free surfaces are there for the soap film? Tell me. How many free surfaces are there for the soap film? Does it have only one surface or two surfaces? Three surfaces. Suppose here, U-shaped metal frame is there. This is U-shaped metal frame and it is a sliding wire. Whenever it is submerged and removed outside, then it is a soap film formed, no? This is one free surface. It is another free surface, no? That's why two free surfaces of the soap film are there. Two free surfaces of the soap film are there. Okay. Swarn, Sriram, Kalyanam, Karthik. Okay, how we got four? Only two free surfaces of the soap film are there. Okay. Are you following now? Karthik. Hey, Karthik. Okay. So here, this side, this surface is one free surface. That side, back side surface is one surface. These are the free surface only. These edges are in contact with the wire. That's why these are not free surfaces. Only this out, the shaded part in this direction is free surface. Backward direction is the free surface. Only two free surfaces are there for the soap film. Okay, now here suppose then you do not apply any force on this wire in this direction. If you do not apply any external force on this wire in this direction, because of surface tension property, here this sliding wire, the molecules of the soap film are in contact here. The molecules of the soap film are in contact with the sliding wire. Because of that, those molecules of the soap film which are in contact with the sliding wire are attracted by adjacent molecules of the soap film, and they pull the molecules in contact with the sliding wire inwards due to opposite forces. That's why the wire comes in this direction, so that area decreases. But in order to increase the surface area, whatever the force due to surface tension acts in this direction. Force due to surface tension means, tell me, what is the force due to surface tension? Force due to surface tension acts on the sliding wire is what? Surface tension of the soap film is say capital T. Then what is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the sliding wire? Length of the free liquid surface in contact with the sliding wire is how much? Length of the free liquid surface in contact with the sliding wire is how much? Length of the free liquid surface in contact with the sliding wire means this side is in contact with the wire, and back side is also in contact with the wire. That's why, what is the total length of the free surface of liquid in contact with the wire is equal to 2b. Okay, so force due to surface tension acts on this wire in this direction is equal to T into 2b. Force due to surface tension acts on the sliding wire. Force due to surface tension acts on sliding wire. Acts on sliding wire is equal to T into 2B. Okay. Therefore, force required to move the sliding wire outwards. Minimum force required to move sliding wire outwards to increase the surface area F dash is equal to F, which is equal to T into 2B. Okay? And if surface tension wala pan chese suppose it vaipu undante, anala sliding wire it vaipu vachestundi. But in order to prevent them to move towards left side, the minimum force required to move the sliding wire outwards is equal to at least equal to force due to surface tension. Then the sliding wire will move with constant speed in this direction, and after certain time, suppose the sliding wire reaches the position here. So that sliding wire displaces by a length equal to say x. Then what is the work done by this section force? Work done by this section force on the sliding wire in displaces it through a distance equal to x is what? So therefore, work done by external force F dash to displace through a distance x is equal to F dash into x. Endukante constant force na apply chestunte itla move chestuntam. Given the sliding wire moving this direction towards right, there is no change in the force due to surface tension acts on the sliding wire. Because when the sliding wire is moving this direction, the surface area of the soap film increases. That is because the number of soap molecules inside the surface film comes onto the surface of the soap film. But not distance between the two molecules increases. And whenever the sliding wire is moving in this direction, then number of molecules on the surface of the soap film increases. But there is no change in the distance among the molecules of the surface of the soap film. whenever there is no change in the distance among the molecules of the soap film, no change in the force due to surface tension. So always force due to surface tension acts on the sliding wire towards left is same. That's why same force is needed on the sliding wire to move outwards is equal to F dash, that is equal to this force only. Okay, by applying this force, constant force F dash, the sliding wire is displaced through a distance x. Then work done by the external force on the displaced through a distance, work done by external force to displace wire, sliding wire, to displace the sliding wire through a distance x is equal to W is equal to F dash into F dash means T into 2B into x. That is equal to T into 2 into BX. What is the B into X? B is this one, X is this one. That means this is the increase in area on one side. B into X and A. Sliding wire ikkada ikkada daaka display chesinappudu, it is the increase in surface. So increase in surface area ante ikkada nunchi ikkada varaku, whenever the sliding wire is displaced through a distance X, this is the increase in surface area on one side. Back side kuda untundi kada, that increase in area on the other side is the opposite side is also equal to b into x. Totally 2 into bx is the total increase in surface area of the soap film when the wire is displaced through a distance equal to x. So this is equal to t into increase in surface area of the soap film. Okay, where delta a is equal to 2 into bx, that is equal to increase in surface area, increase in surface area of soap film. So to increase the surface area of the soap film by delta A amount, what is the work to be done by external agent? It means T into delta A. That is very, very important formula. The amount of work done to increase the surface area of the soap film against the surface tension is equal to, you know, surface tension wala panchese force it vai kunde against the force due to surface tension by applying external force, the surface area of the soap film is increased by delta A. That's why work done to increase the surface area, work done to increase the surface area of the liquid against the surface tension is equal to surface tension into increase in area. The area increase of film, increase in surface area of the soap film here. Okay, so this is very, very important. Therefore, what is the work done to increase the unit surface area of the soap film? Here, this is numerically equal to surface energy, increase in surface energy of the soap film. This, whatever the work done increasing the surface area of the soap film, that is equal to surface energy. Surface energy. Okay. Work done to increase unit surface area. Work done to increase unit surface area is equal to W by work done to increase the this much area of the soap surface. Surface of liquid is W. Work done to increase the unit surface area is W by delta A, which is equal to numerical equal to T now. That is equal to surface tension. So work done to increase the unit surface area of the liquid surface, unit area of the liquid surface is equal to numerical equal to surface tension. This point is also very, very important. No. Here the thickness of the liquid film may be decreased. Thickness of the liquid film decreases, but surface area increases. Surface area into thickness T is the volume. Now volume remains constant, but whenever area decreases, thickness of the liquid film decreases, and area surface area of the liquid film increases. It is not the thickness. This side is the thickness. It is the thickness. Okay, thickness decreases, but area increases. Area into thickness is the volume. Siddhu, okay, Siddhu. Thickness decreases. Length of the wire in contact will decrease. No, length of the wire is always constant. whenever the sliding bar is moving in this direction, number of molecules inside the liquid film come onto the surface of the liquid. Due to the surface area increase, thickness of the liquid film decreases. But there is no change among the there is no change in the distance between any two adjacent molecules. Okay, that's why here it does not obey the Hooke's law. It does not obey the Hooke's law. Like distance among the molecules is not law. That's why it does not obey the Hooke's law. Okay. No doubt. Shall I read this one? Why I have taken 2B? You see, what is the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire outside? The free liquid surface is this one. The length of the free liquid surface in contact with the sliding wire means this is equal to B, because this side is B, means this also B. Back side is also the length of the free liquid surface in contact with the wire is equal to B. So totally 2B free. To be length of the free liquid surface is in contact with the sliding wire. That's why force due to surface tension acts on the sliding wire inverse is equal to T into 2B. At least the equivalent force to be applied on the wire to move it in outwards. Okay. See, just like cuboid, we can take, or suppose if the length is more. It is the rectangle cross section with some thickness, you can imagine. Okay, right, next. So you have to remember this formula. Some note points we have to discuss based on this concept. They are also very, very important. Some note points. Work done to produce the liquid drop of radius smaller. Initially, there is no liquid drop. Suppose you take a straw. Dip inside the water and remove them out. Then slowly pour the air. As you blow the air into the straw. And slowly the liquid drop is formed, no? The liquid comes out drop by drop like that, no? So what is the work done to produce the liquid drop of radius smaller? Yes, and the mouth mana yen blow chestunnam kabatti konda pressure apply chestunnattu kada. So by blowing air, what is the work done on the water inside the straw to come out in the form of a drop of radius smaller? Initially there is no drop, so work done to produce liquid drop of radius capillar is already we know. Work done to increase the surface area of the liquid is equal to surface tension into increase in area. Am I right? Initially there is no liquid drop, so radius is zero. But finally, the liquid drop is produced of radius capillar. So what is the increase in area? Final radius of this liquid drop is capillar. So surface area of the liquid drop is 4π r². Initially there is no drop, so initial area is zero. So increase in surface area is T into 4π r². This is the work done to produce the liquid drop of radius capillar, where T is the surface tension. Okay. Second one, work done to increase the radius of drop from radius r1 to r2 is W is equal to formula is same T into increase in surface area. Initially there is a liquid drop of radius capital R1. So initial surface area of the liquid drop is equal to 4 pi R1 square. But finally, 4 pi R1 square. But finally, increase the radius of the soap liquid drop from R1 to R2. That's why final area of the soap liquid drop is 4 pi R2 square. So what is the increase in surface area? 4 pi R2 square minus 4 pi R1 square. This is the work done to increase the radius of liquid drop from R1 to R2. Therefore, W is equal to P into 4 pi into R2 square minus R1 square. Third one, suppose there is a big drop. There is a big drop of radius capital R. There is a big drop of radius capital R. It is split into small droplets, n droplets. It is split into n identical droplets. N identical droplets. It is split into n identical droplets. What is the work to be done? Whenever the big drop is split into n identical droplets, is the surface area of the all small drops increase compared with the surface area or decrease? Tell me. When big drop is split into n identical droplets, is the surface area increase or decrease? When big drop is split into n identical droplets, is the surface area increase or decrease? Decrease. No, increase. Because number of free surfaces are there, no? Initially, there is only one free surface. When it is divided into n identical droplets, free surfaces increase. That's why total surface area of all the n small droplets is greater than big droplet, big drop. That's why surface area increases. In order to increase the surface area, some work is to be done, no? What is that work done? Work done is equal to general formula is surface tension into increase in surface area, that is fixed only. So surface tension into final surface area minus initial surface area. Final surface area of all the free droplets minus initial surface area of this one. Suppose we are not given radius of each small droplet, that is a smaller. That is equal to T into surface area of each droplet is equal to 4 pi small r square. In that way, n droplets are there. The surface area of n droplets is equal to n into 4 pi r square minus initial surface area of the big drop, that is equal to 4 pi capital r square. We are given only n smaller capital r and T. Small r is not given. So we have to find the relation between small r and capital r. When the big drop is divided into n droplets, there is no change in the volume of the entire liquid. There is no change in the volume of the entire liquid. This is the equation one. So, volume of big drop, that means 4 third pi capital R cube, must be equal to volume of n droplets, n into 4 by 3 pi small r cube. 4 by 3 pi, 4 by 3 pi cancel. Then small r is equal to r by n to power of 1 by 3, we can write now. Because R cube is equal to n into small r cube. R n is equal to capital R, sorry. Small r cube is equal to R cube by n. R small r is equal to R by n power of 1 by 3. Okay, radius of the small drop is equal to this one. Now we substitute this value here. Therefore, from 1, W is equal to T into n into 4 pi into small r means capital R by n power of 1 by 3. N power of 1 by 3. Whole square is there. Minus 4 pi capital R square. So this is equal to T into 4 pi, of course, we can write outside. 4 pi capital R square, 4 pi capital R square, we can write outside. You write outside. Okay, W is equal to T into 4 pi capital R square, 4 pi capital R square, you write outside. 4 pi capital R square into here n by n into 1 by n to power of 1 by 3 whole square means n by n to power of 2 by 3 minus 1. Okay? That implies W is equal to T into 4 pi capital R square into whatever n by n power of 2 by 3. N power of 1 into n power of minus 2 by 3. N power of 1 minus 2 by 3. That means n power of 1 by 3. So n power of 1 by 3 minus 1. This is the work done to split the big drop into n identical droplets. Okay, big drop ni n identical droplets ka convert cheyalante. What will be done is equal to T into 4 pi capital R square of n power of 1 by 3 minus 1. Because small liquid drop, B big liquid drop ka marindante surface energy decrease avutuna increase avutuna when a big liquid drop is converted into n droplets as the surface area increases surface energy increases whatever the work done increasing the surface area that is stored in the small liquid drops as the surface energies so here surface energy increases when n big drop is converted into n identical droplets the surface energy increases for when big drop split into n identical droplets n droplets comma as surface area increases surface energy also increases surface energy also increase okay suppose soap bubble work to produce the soap bubble of radius Kepler work done to produce the soap bubble of radius Kepler p into increase in surface area initially you dip the straw in a soap bubble sorry in soap solution and remove out and slowly you blow the air into the straw then slowly the soap bubble gradually produces as long as you blow the air into them the size of the soap bubble gradually increases suppose there is a soap bubble of radius Kepler bubble maker in bubble maker it is happen like that only no so here to increase the radius of the soap bubble from 0 to Kepler initial the soap bubble layer 0 radius to increase the soap bubble of radius Kepler what is the work done so the work done to increase the soap bubble of radius Kepler is equal to e into increase in surface area delta a increase in surface area delta a means final surface area minus initial surface area what is the final surface area tell me what is the final surface area radius of the soap bubble is r what is the final surface area what is the final surface area of the free liquid surface free surface of the soap bubble in case of soap bubble inside the soap bubble there is no matter that's why inside surface is also free surface and outer surface is also free surface so total free surface total area of the free liquid total area of the this soap bubble is equal to inner surface area 4 pi Kepler square outer surface area 4 pi r square because the thickness is negligible That's why totally 8 pi r square. So 2 into 4 pi r square you write. 2 into 4 pi r square. It is the final surface area of the soap bubble minus initial surface area 0. Therefore, P into 8 pi r square is the work done to produce the soap bubble of radius Kepler. What is the work done to produce the what is the work done to increase the radius of the soap bubble from R1 to R2? What is the work done to increase the radius of the soap bubble from R1 to R2? What is the work to be done to increase the radius of the soap bubble from R1 to R2? Fifth one. Work done to increase radius of soap bubble R1 to R2 work done to increase the radius from R1 to R2 of soap bubble W is equal to T into increase in surface area T into final surface area of the soap bubble is 8 pi R2 square Minus initial surface area of the soap bubble 8 pi R1 square because 2 into 4 pi R2 square minus 2 into 4 pi R1 square that's why 8 pi R2 square minus 8 pi R1 square therefore T into 8 pi R2 square minus R1 square this is the work to be done to increase the radius of the soap bubble from R1 to R2. Okay. Next. Suppose on the surface of the liquid, a circular disc is kept. It is floating over the surface of the liquid. Circular disc. On the surface of liquid, a circular disc of radius capital R is kept. What is the work to be done? To remove the disc from the surface of the liquid against the surface tension. Surface tension against the disc ni bayataki remove cheyalante enta force ante already inda cheppar p into 2 pi r enta work cheyali. What is the work to be done to remove the circular disc from the surface of the liquid? Initial ga ettondi free liquid surface ante other than disc remaining area of the liquid is the free surface. Disc ni remove chesa anko disc yokka surface area ent undo anta area increase avutundi ka free surface area increase avutundi kada. That's why the increase in surface area of the free liquid surface is equal to area of this disc in contact with the liquid surface. Enta area of the disc liquid tho contact lo undo that is the increase in surface area of the liquid. So work done to remove disc from surface of liquid against the surface tension w is equal to t into delta a. That is there is no change here. Indaka disk ikkadunnappudu ee free liquids ikka disk area entundo anta area ga liquid surface disk tho contact lo undi kaabatti free surface kaadu and it is removed. Whatever the area of the liquid surface in contact with the disk, that becomes free now from the disk. That's why increase in surface area, free surface of the liquid is equal to area of the disk only. That's why T into area of the disk. Or area of the body, surface area of the body in contact with the surface of liquid. Area of contact of body with liquid surface. That is important point here. Therefore, W is equal to T into area of contact of the body with liquid surface is equal to pi r square. This is the answer. Pi r square. Okay. So T into pi r square. Next, suppose annular disc is kept over the surface of liquid. What is the work to be done to remove the annular disc from the surface of the liquid? Seventh one, annular disc. Work required to remove the annular disc from the surface of the liquid against the surface tension is equal to surface tension into area of contact of the annular disc. Area of contact of annular disc. Annular disc. With surface of liquid. Surface tension into area of contact of the annular disc with the surface of the liquid. That is equal to. Tell me, what is the surface area of the annular disc in contact with the surface area of the liquid? I into capital R square minus small r square. No? Okay. Total annular disc is liquid surface mein float avutunnapudu. Area of the solid surface in contact with the liquid and the e part ekka contact lo undedi adlo water ekka liquid ekka undedi kaabatti this shared part is the area of contact of the solid with the surface of the liquid. That is the increase in area when it is removed. Okay, therefore from total outer area subtract the area of the hole, that means pi capital R square minus pi small r square. The annual disk aithe it is small r, it is capital R. Okay, therefore work done is equal to t into pi of R square minus small r square. It is the work to be done to remove the annular disc from the surface of the liquid against the surface tension. Against the surface tension. Okay. Next. suppose here rectangular plate is there over the surface of liquid. Last point. Rectangular plate. Okay, okay. Last 1 minute. Last minute. Suppose one rectangular plate is there over the surface of liquid. Floating. It is floating over the surface of liquid. Okay. Length L, breadth B. It is floating over the surface of liquid. So work required. Work required. Work required to remove the rectangle plate from the surface of liquid. Work done to remove. Date from the surface of liquid. From surface of liquid against the surface tension. Against surface tension. W is equal to surface tension into the surface area of the rectangle plate in contact with the surface of the liquid. What is the value? Tell me. L into B. L into B only. L into B. Okay, therefore, surface tension into area of contact of the body rectangle plate in the surface of the liquid, that is equal to T into L into B. Very good. This is the work done, work to be done to remove the plate from the surface of the liquid against the surface tension. So you have to remember only one point. When the solid surface is in contact with the liquid surface, in order to remove the body against the surface tension, work to be done, minimum work to be done is equal to surface tension into surface area of the body in contact with the free liquid surface. Liquid surface to yanta area of the body contact onto the area ne increase in area of the liquid surface out. Kabatti into area of contact of the rectangle plate and in contact with the liquid surface is L into B. So in this way you have to do. Okay na? Right. Today, based on this, you have to do the problems. Today you have to do the problems based on these concepts. And mains paper today you have to complete. Tomorrow I will discuss the advanced paper. Okay. Right. Have a nice day. I'm signing out. Bye all of you. One minute, Mr. Roshan. No, not Roshan. Sriram. At a hole in annular disc, film occurs. No, in the annular disc, suppose if you remove the annular disc, whatever the area of this annular disc, that amount of area, free surface of liquid increase, no? Area of the free liquid surface increased by this amount only, shared part only. When you remove from them, actually whenever this annular disc is kept over the surface of the liquid, whatever the shared part, that is the surface of the annular disc in contact with the liquid surface. When you remove them, this amount of area of the liquid increase, no? Surface area of the liquid increase, no? That's why pi into cap law square minus small law square is the area of the shared part. That amount of surface area of the liquid increase when you remove them. Okay. So, work done is equal to this one. Right. Okay, I will upload now only. Right. Okay, and have a nice day. I'm signing out. Bye all of you. Have lunch and take rest for 1 hour. Right.